Hi, everybody. Welcome to another lead-in with Lauren. Go Seahawks. Bloody cold here in Edmonton. Woo. Anyway, I want to talk to you about your mentorship strategy. First of all, do you have one? Who are your mentors, both on a regular basis or perhaps on a more spontaneous basis? And why do you want to talk to them? And how do you go about doing it? And here's why and how I want to share that with you. First of all, I'm asked, thank goodness, and I'm grateful by a lot of people for time to, frankly, because they want to kick something around and to in a mentorship type role. And I try to be as generous as possible. And a lot of times I can't be as responsive because of just my calendar so jam-packed. But I try to be there for everybody. However, I want to share with you some thoughts around how you might do that most effectively. So I got kind of buckets of people that I work with. I've got that when they ask me, I'm going to call in a nice kind of way, a bucket of people that are frankly kind of happy to have a cup of coffee with me, but they're really not, they just don't know what they want to do next. And my reaction, and I don't really say this to them because I'm kinder and I want to be a good listener, is like, well, you know, welcome to the friggin' club. Like, you know, you're kind of like, we're all kind of in that. I'm sorry to tell you this, but most of us never actually get it real clear where we're not kind of trying to ask ourselves what we might do next. So that's a pretty open bucket. The people that I can make the biggest contribution to are people that have given a lot of thought to what they really want to get out of this conversation. And typically, here's what they do well. They have thought about their purpose. And they, even though they may not be clear about their purpose, they tend to ask the context around what might and how might they respond to doing something that would add to kind of their purpose. Or perhaps in a more advanced stage, they are starting to thoughtfully build a body of work. And they want to ask a question around or questions or kick around in the context of a body of work that they're developing. So when they're in that frame, when they prepare that way, even though their question might be, what might I do next in terms of choices of a career or choices of activity, when they frame it up in the context of as best as they know, and they understand, you know, what they're good at, what they like to do, kind of their purpose in life. And they're not all, and we're not always completely clear about that at all. But the more that they're in that, and a body of work, that expertise that they're trying to develop, gosh, I think they and I get a lot more out of that conversation. So as you're going about your objective around meeting with your mentor, part of it is getting on that person's calendar for sure, but that's just the beginning. And part of it is being prepared to ask the questions. However, the really advanced contribution is when you've already started to think about how the responses to those questions are going to add to your purpose and a body of work and expertise that you're trying to build. As trivial as the questions may be. So I don't know if that helps you, but let me just add and sum up in this way. Have a mentorship strategy. Know who those people are and how they help build to way beyond just connection, how they help build to your understanding and growth and development, both towards your purpose and to a body of work you're developing. And when you do that, I think you'll really create clarity with your mentorship strategy. And I think you and the people that you're going to reach out to will both get a lot more of it. I don't know if that's helpful. I hope it is. It's helpful to me and keep growing, and I'll try and do the same and keep mentoring, and we'll all work on it. Thanks again. Great seeing you. Join us on our socials. Subscribe to LaurenRubis.com. Hang out with us. You drive us. Thanks. Bye for now.